The ocean is not a quiet place. There's the sound of the seascape, the rustling of wind blowing over the water, the crashing of waves, the trickling of bubbles that rise to the surface and burst, and the cracking of polar ice. There's also the sound of life. Some fish grunt, others chirp or hum, shrimps crackle, dolphins whistle, some whales sing sophisticated songs. It's one thing for an occasional lightning strike or a hurricane to disrupt this symphony. It's quite another when outside sounds become pervasive. That's what human activities like shipping have done. They're making our oceans noisier. This noise is drowning out the sounds marine animals rely upon to survive. And this is a big problem. In water, sound waves travel faster and farther than in the air, and so sound is a key sensory signal in the ocean. Marine mammals like dolphins and whales use a variety of calls to identify and talk to each other and to bond. Invertebrate fishes and other marine animals also intentionally produce sound and use sounds to navigate, to find suitable habitats and to locate food. Sound helps marine animals mark their territories and warn off predators. It also helps them call upon potential mates. But since the Industrial Revolution, humans have bombarded the ocean with a broad range of sound frequencies. One of the most widespread sources is commercial ships that carry oil, containers, or other cargo, like the massive Ever Given that got stuck in the Suez Canal in March 2021. Some ship sound comes from the onboard machinery. Some comes from the water flowing around the hull. But the loudest sound comes from the propeller. When a propeller rotates quickly, it creates low pressure locally, which causes the formation of vapor-filled bubbles that first grow, then collapse, leaving behind a trail of loud noise in a phenomenon called cavitation. Since World War II, the number of ships plying our oceans has risen consistently. In fact, studies show a quadrupling of ship traffic in just 20 years between 1992 and 2012. This has contributed to a considerable increase in both low and high frequency noise along major shipping routes. Arrays of air guns aboard seismic survey vessels also release extremely loud explosive pulses of compressed air to map the seabed for scientific purposes and to find oil and gas deposits. The repetitive high energy booms from a single air gun can be as loud as a dynamite explosion. So loud that scientists have recorded these sounds up to 4,000 kilometers or 2,500 miles away from the survey vessel. Fishers use sonar to locate fish. There's sound from trawlers scraping the seabed and from fishers setting off dynamite to stun or kill reef fish. Navies use active sonar to detect hidden underwater submarines. And explosions of missiles and bombs during military exercises emit destructive, wide-ranging noise. Even the sound from planes flying over the ocean and from construction along the coast can pervade the waters. Since much of these sounds overlap with frequencies within the hearing range of marine animals, noise from human activities is disrupting these animals' environment and behavior. For example, dolphins have been found to change their direction of travel in response to ship traffic and even to swim erratically and increase their traveling speed when ships approach them. These mammals will also spend less time resting and socializing in noisy waters. Sometimes, they change their calls. It's like having to shout over loud music in a restaurant. In response to shipping noise, beaked whales have been observed not only to reduce the area in which they hunt, but also to make fewer successful attempts at catching prey. In Chile's Patagonia, researchers tracked the path a single blue whale swam to avoid hundreds of vessels. This region is one of the most important breeding grounds for a blue whale subspecies living in the southeastern Pacific. But marine traffic and the sound it emits is creating a disturbance that researchers say could affect the whale's feeding behavior and hurt conservation efforts. Similarly, pulses of high-intensity sounds from seismic surveys have been shown to reduce the sightings of mammals like baleen whales. One study even found that endangered African penguins started avoiding their preferred feeding grounds when seismic activities began within 100 kilometers of their colony in South Africa. Studies have also suggested that noise from seismic surveys can impair the hearing abilities of some fishes. But there's still a lot we don't know about how noise affects marine animals. This is simply because we haven't studied many species, including most fishes and invertebrates and even many mammals. These gaps in information could mean we're underestimating how noise pollution affects marine animals. The good news is that there are ways to turn down the volume. Theoretically, you could take the noisiest ships out of the water and reroute shipping traffic away from sensitive marine animal habitats. Reducing ship speeds would also help, although perhaps not with all vessels. New solutions are emerging. For instance, starting in 2015, Maersk, the world's largest container shipping company, modified 11 of its ships in a $100 million radical retrofit fuel efficiency program. Changes included installing more efficient and quieter propellers and changing the ship's bows to reduce drag. The result? Researchers measured the sounds produced by 5 of these ships and found that the modified vessels were 6 to 8 decibels quieter than the originals. A significant decrease. Also, companies like Shell, Total, ExxonMobil are developing marine vibrators that are quieter alternatives to the ear-splittingly loud air guns used in offshore seismic surveys. Many such solutions will need testing. They will need money. And if they work, their widespread and fast adoption will require international cooperation. For now, most of the major international agreements that address noise reduction are voluntary in nature. So, will countries and companies step up and chart a quieter path through the oceans? It is possible to do. Until then, marine animals will have to continue trying to hear and be heard in a noisier ocean. Thank you.